Morning, everybody. Philip here from Tripwire Racing. So, we've got the rusty old BlackBerry 55 here loaded up on the trailer. It's got an appointment with the State Patrol today. See if we can get some paperwork on this thing. Because I'm not going to waste a bunch of money trying to make this nasty old thing run. Till I know that I actually own it. So let's get this adventure started. Well, here we are at the State Patrol inspection office. Made it in one piece. 55 still on the trailer. Looks like we got a couple minutes to wait. We're like 15 minutes early. So the story with this car, from what I've been told, this thing got parked in 1969, this guy's backyard, and sat there rotting until he passed away last year. His son is cleaning up the property. There was also a 69 Camaro sitting there that had been parked since the late 70s, I guess, rotting. He's got a friend of mine doing all the metal work to fix that. And they made a trade deal on this 55 for some of the labor. And then I made a trade deal for labor to put an engine in Aaron's 55 Chevy for the car. So basically it's a free 55 Chevy. Couldn't say no to that. And it needs a lot of work, a lot of metal. The floor is completely gone. The trunk end rails are gone. The doors are pretty much junk. The thing sat with the driver's side window rolled down, I guess since the 60s. So there's nothing left at the bottom of that door. The rocker panel's completely gone. You can see all the way to the transmission on the driver's side. There's absolutely no floor left. There's really nothing holding the seat in. Thing's pretty sad, but I'm gonna try to save it. The roof and the quarter panels are there. So I guess once I get done with the inspection here, I'll be back and tell you how that all went. All right, so we're all done with the State Patrol. Went fairly smoothly. Took about a half hour. They just checked the VIN number on the doorpost. They looked for the VIN number on the frame, couldn't find it because it's so rusty. Nothing legible there. Found the VIN number on the engine block. Surprisingly enough, it's a numbers matching car. Woo! Now the next step is to go over to the DMV, hand in the paperwork, so I can actually get the registration on this thing. I think I'll probably have to do the 3-year title search deal. It's usually what they do. The lady here didn't mention any of that, so we'll see what happens. Also, today is my mom's birthday, so happy birthday, Mom. Big shout out there. Next step, we're going to head over to the Department of Motor Vehicles and turn in this paperwork and see what happens. And just got done with the DMV. I brought the card just so they wouldn't try to charge me too much tax on the value. Because, you know, they'd like to do that sometimes. State's got to get their money. So the whole deal with this car is the guy that owned it passed away. Family couldn't find a title anywhere. So I had to file what they call ownership in doubt. So basically I own the car, but I can't prove I owned it. So now I got this registration in my name, and we have to wait 3 years for a title. So somebody could show up and say they own it. I don't think that's going to be an option here because I know where the car came from. So yeah, that's kind of that deal with that. we'll get this thing home, get it off the trailer, start working on something else. This whole process took like 3 hours. The fee at the DMV was $225. I had to buy license plates for the car. Did the collector plates, so I don't have to buy tabs for it. I would have had to spend that anyways at some point in time, so that's all good. So yeah, I guess stay tuned. We'll start cutting this thing up here eventually. Have a good day.